I'm accomplishing something for me. What's stopping you from being the guy that goes home and changes your life?
It's not easy to come in here and pick shit out of yourself.
I was a failure. I'm gonna change my life.
Couch potato, Gary Roberts, you are dead.
That's just a warm up, dude. Fucking man. Never gets easier, man.
Am I interrupting something, gentlemen?
Wow, that was the hardest workout I've ever had.
Well, I'm actually contemplating suicide.
What? Yeah! We're going to talk about sex. Hey, you look more doable.
You're 3 steps away. Don't stop yet. Come on, work until the time is up.
No, I was offered sex.
You get 2 minutes rest afterwards. Don't give me that. Jumping over like this? Bullshit.
I don't want to see any of this crap.
And every rep counts.
I'm going to start working on my stuff. I'm going to change me, and let's see if other shit comes together. Who am I being? Hardest one yet, buddy. What week? I've lost track now. I know I'm into my, this is the beginning of my 4th week for Paleo. So, we've got to be 7 weeks. I think week 7, lots happening. So I got a couple things to talk about. Should I just go?
Sure.
Okay. Well, one, I can talk a little bit. We have kids in the background. So are we allowed to talk about sex?
Yeah.
We are?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't know if that's something we'd talk about. This is kind of, you know, I've been going through this personal transformation. I think more this week has to do with internal things I'm going through than actual results at the gym. I mean, every day is an ass kicking, so it's hard to judge until I go back and redo some of the workouts. That's my daddy. And then also, when I come home, I stand on the scale and I look at myself. And you know, I've tried to avoid, you know, I'm in the video business also. I try to cut my mind off that I know I'm fat, but I don't even want to look at it. And so what I tend to do is I get animated and I'm very mobile and I don't really mind the video because I know I'm always moving, and I've tricked my mind into believing that other people, if I'm moving really fast and I got my hands in front of me like this, that people won't notice how fat I've gotten. I've been fearing still pictures for years. Don't want to look at them. Don't even want to go there. And now, real cool, when I said look at myself naked, I look in the mirror and I'm like trying to see the results. And my mind still sees, you know, the fat dude. But now, just this week, in fact, yesterday, so we're at Disneyland, we're taking pictures. And it's the first time that I can remember looking at a picture. You know, when I look at a picture of myself, it's like, I know I have to prepare myself for the nastiness that I'm about to see because I'm so disgusted. But yesterday was the first time I went on a roller coaster, and you know, everyone's like, and you go and look at the picture, and I looked and I said, hey, I could see the results. It was the first time I recall looking at a picture of myself and saying, hey, that dude's not bad looking. Looks long. I gotta sign in. I know he can make a change just like me, eat a little bit healthier. Like already in a month, my belly was out to here. In just a couple months of making a change, it shrinks. And your walking would be so much easier if you weren't carrying around the extra weight.
Oh, I know.
Oh yeah, he used to be sweating all over and barely moving the whole time. And now he just like, he just works through every workout.
Well, he used to modify for me, and you don't modify.
Yeah, he's not modified. He's actually jumped from like a level 1 modified to now he's like borderlining on like a lot of level 2 workouts. So he's just getting stronger. His movements are solid. He's just overall just improving amazingly. So, and it's been what, 6 weeks, 7 weeks, something like that?
And so that all leads me to my main point today, which maybe we'll have to leave the room. It's like, McKenna, hey, could you guys leave the room? Go to the other side. I got to talk about something real quick. Are we allowed to talk about that? I was talking to you off camera, and you said, so, any feedback from the missus, from the wife, is, are you getting any more? And I look at you, and I was like, you know, I see results, but I'm not seeing any benefit in the bed yet. You know, I haven't seen it. So that was on the tip of my mind. And so I decided to take it upon myself to bring it up with, you know, Anissa. I said, you know, I'm a little disappointed. She's like, why? And I said, because to be perfectly honest with you, you know, again, I told you I'm looking any little feedback to keep me motivated. Like you being here, that's motivating. Seeing pounds come off the scale, that's motivating. Seeing one more pull-up or one more push-up or lasting a little bit longer in the WOD, that's motivating. And now when you ask me about the misses, is there any more attention? I really hadn't seen it. Now, mind you, I have become a fat dude, and I would say not very desirable over the last, you know, I've been married 18 years. Maybe, you know, I wouldn't want to have sex with myself either, right? Now, I'm not putting down...
Is this going
to
be on...
Yeah, not literally.
On record?
We're going to go through a portion of the Bergner warm-up, which essentially is each piece to a snatch. We're only going to go as far as the hang power snatch when you're doing your PVC pass-throughs. Okay? Wrap it around, move your hands in a little bit more, keep going until you find that one where there's a sticky spot, but you can still go. Reach around, and you're going to put your fingers over the top of your thumb. Good. Your feet are underneath your hips. You're going to have a nice tall chest, nice tight abs. When you're doing the down and up, your back is staying flat. We're not bending forward. It's just straight down. You're going to keep the elbows nice and loose so they can come along for a ride now. Okay?
I will say, as a fat dude, trying to have sex is like a sumo wrestler trying to dance in the china shop. You know, it's not very pretty and things are getting broken. And so it's not something I would want to watch. You know, you're trying to enjoy it, but you know you're just not wanting to watch it. So anyways, I bring up the issue to Anissa. I say, hey, I'm kind of disappointed because you've given me positive feedback, but it's no different than a feedback I might get from a neighbor or my grandma. Like, hey, good for you, so proud of you. She's like, what do you mean? And I was like, well, as a man and a horny man, you know, just because you get fat doesn't mean you, I mean, if anything, you're more horny because nobody wants to touch you. not even your spouse. So I said, well, you know, your compliments are no different than a stranger. I would hope to be a little bit, and I'm trying to be a certain, I'm trying to hint towards what I'm getting at without actually saying it, but I have to basically spell it out. And you know what she says? She says something so surprising, it totally caught me off guard. I did not expect it. And she says, well, I didn't notice, and I didn't want to come off as shallow by saying, hey, you look more doable. And I said, hey, I've come for years without any compliments. Damn it, be shallow. Tell me I'm more doable. I need to hear that right now.
Yep. Go ahead, Lisa, try it. Okay. Now be forceful with your jump. Okay.
Fast forward a couple hours, and you know, let's just say something happens, and you know, a little exploring of the bodies, and you notice, like, you know, she's saying, man, there used to be more, like, when I put my hand like this, you know, it used to have to climb up this big roll and back down, and now it's just more like a little hill. Like, you look more just like an average out of shape guy. But definitely a huge difference. And, you know, to keep it clean, it was a very sexy experience. And I'll just leave it at that. But
keep it going. Keep it. Oh, sure. Yeah. It's balance.
And look at my dad. He likes to eat too. But stand up. See, I was blessed with being just a hint taller. Hint taller than this old man, but if I look, he can barely walk because of bad knees.
Keep those shoulders active. Keep the shoulders active and push it up to the sky. Push it up. Don't let your elbows bend. You'll wear out faster if you let those elbows bend. Down and back, down and back.
And you have had open heart surgery.
Right.
Open. Tell them. tell me?
I've had a triple bypass, aortic valve replacement, and a pacemaker. And in one stent.
And
it didn't work.
Bad circulation.
Carotid artery rooting. Root out.
Cleaning. So not good.
What causes all that?
Improper eating. I mean, and my dad died of a heart attack at 56. My brother died of a heart attack at 56.
Looking good. It's those shoes. Those orange shoes. Come on, little miss.
So anyways, I wanted to come to the gym, so hopefully he can, I was talking about, I need any little motivation I can do to keep on target. I want my dad to see his son, you know, getting beat down, getting motivated. It'll motivate you to walk a little bit harder when you get home.
Gary, you coming in tomorrow?
Yes.
Excellent, you're gonna love it. Keep going, guys. It's a 30-minute limit.
I am absolutely feeling strong, like no feelings of cheating. Like when people were eating corn dogs last night, and I was like, no, not even going there.
You're three steps away, don't stop yet. Big ones. There's two, one more big one. You're on camera. Look pretty and work hard. Yeah, but you're in the shot.
And your ability to, you know, just do this is gone, right? 67. And I don't even know, I mean, maybe we're not supposed to talk about this. I won't say personally, but 67, I still want to be, you know, hitting, I mean.
Good.
You know, to put it lightly, I couldn't tie my shoes before, right? So with the belly, I can't do this simple thing, like tie my shoe. I'd have to put the knee down here and like roll the belly over it and get like this and be like that. I mean, it's like crazy.
Deep breaths, in through the nose, out through the mouth. Lock those shoulders out, lock those elbows.
What is CrossFit? It's a constantly varied functional movement at a high intensity by definition.
Keep going, buddy. Down and back. And all you have is those bumper plate burpees left on those. And then the horrible round is over. Rest is just coasting.
It's when I first got into CrossFit, I didn't know what it meant at all. Absolutely. But now you're asking me what is CrossFit. It's almost like asking me what is the meaning of life. I mean, which angle do you want to attack it? There's so many sides to the equation and so many different angles. What's the meaning of life, Sevi? What's the meaning of life? I mean, it could be anything. To me, that's how big CrossFit is. It's so grand of a scale that I am yet to even fully comprehending it. Like, I'm just starting to now see changes, but I feel like I could be doing CrossFit for 2 or 3 years and not even fully understand what it means. But like you don't even know what it means yet. I haven't even told, well, I tried to tell.
Awesome. He's kind of an animal. He just goes for it. He never slows down. This is actually the slowest I've ever seen him move since he's been in here, but bumper plate burpees are never fast. But he comes in, puts 110% in every single time, and you can see, like, he has just made huge strides. His movements are good. He's dropped 20 or 30 pounds, we're in 6 or 7 weeks right now. It's just like, the weight's peeling off and he's getting stronger. You worked for 30 minutes straight and you worked hard, so don't even worry about it.
Not a DNF-er.
I hate to tell you this, but everybody's DNF'd at least once in their workout career.